شريك له، والذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير. نحمده ونكملنا ديننا وأتم علينا نعمته ورضينا الإسلام دينا. والله الذي لا إله إلا هو عالم الغيب والشهادة، هو الرحمن الرحيم، هو الخالق البارئ المصور، له الأسماء الحسنى سبحانه وتعالى عما يصفون. أشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا وعظيمنا وقائدنا ومعلمنا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده وعبد ربه حتى أتاه اليقين منه، فاللهم صل عليه وارض اللهم عن زوجاته وآله وصحابته والتابعين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة إلا وصاحبها في النار. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم، إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم، يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت، وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها، وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. يا أيها الناس أنتم الفقراء إلى الله، والله هو الغني الحميد، يشأ يذهبكم ويأتي بخلق جديد، وما ذلك على الله بعزيز. أما بعد، I bear witness that there is no deity worth of worship except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Exalted is He, the creator of universe. I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the last messenger sent to us. يقول ربنا سبحانه وتعالى في محكم التنزيل: وذكرهم بأيام الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the Quran, after he was talking about Musa alayhi salam and his nation and his community, then he ordered Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to remind us about the days of Allah. In our modern language or contemporary language, it's called history. Remind them about their history. Remind them about where they come from. Remind them also about who they are. We are in the month of Rajab, one of the sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to open the gate of success to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after he was disappointed, after he struggled for many years in Mecca trying to implement some reforms, bring some social justice to his community. But the opposition was harsh, was tough. He couldn't do much. Most of the narrations, they said the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at that time, they were less than 100. Imagine that during 10 years, you are repeating the same thing, calling people to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to create an atmosphere where everybody is equal, where you are fighting against transgression, against slavery, against dictatorship, against bad manners, All this time, in the end of the day, you have less than 100. Which is what? 30 per year. Less than 30 per year. If you count the three, four, if you don't count the 4 or 5 years in the beginning. Back and forth with them. جهابلة قريش صناديد قريش telling them that say one thing, I don't want anything from you, I don't want your wealth, I don't need any power, I don't want to be your leader, I don't want to be your king, I don't want to tax your money, all what I need from you is say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله, you will be saved from the hellfire. None of them, none of these big shots, as they call them, wants to hear him. They fight it against him. Anytime he goes somewhere, they follow him. They blocked him. Put him under siege for 3 years. No trade. No business. Not even food. There is no, they call it social or psychological stability at that time. He cannot even afford to have the food in Mecca for his companions. The time comes. يَمْكُرُونَ وَيَمْكُرُ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاكِرِينَ. Allah has his own agenda that humans cannot understand. Allah has his own way to make his religion prevail. Allah, he has his own way to make Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam victorious. Allah, is his own way to save the Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with them. To save them and to open another gate for them to get out and to build what we call today Islamic civilization. That everybody is talking about. That Islamic civilization that we are tasting the fruits of it today. Because if we are sitting in this masjid today, it's because of the effort of those before us. It's the effort of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and his companion. The struggle of the companion. Because until today, somebody will ask this question, then what? We are nothing compared to the other nations today. We don't have any value. In the age of humans, yes, we don't have any value. But in the age of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is another story. For those who are holding on the principle that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Sayyidina Abu Bakr and Sayyidina Bilal and Khabbab, they were holding on, which is Hablullah al-Mateen, al-Quran, which is La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. They never give it up. And we still have today, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, this small community who is holding on that robe of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hablullah al-Mateen, alladhi la yanqati'. The question then, what we can learn from this month. Number one, patience. Nothing in this life comes free. Everything is by al-juhd. Mujahadatu nafs. The third is to have a vision. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has vision. When he went from Mecca to a Taif, he has vision. He doesn't want the deen to stay just in Mecca and then struggle in Mecca and tell Sahaba, you know what, this is what we can do. We cannot do anything else. Let us sit here until we see what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can do for us. This is not the way. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam took those steps to go outside. I couldn't find anybody who can believe in me and in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in my tribe, then I have to look somewhere else. This is why he sent Sahaba radwanullahi alayhim, Sayyidina Ja'far, Sayyidina Uthman, and some Sahaba. He sent them to Al-Habasha. Go there. Not to save the deen. Because sometimes us, we study the history in a wrong way. Saving the deen is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّا نَحْنُ نَزَّلْنَا الذِّكْرَ وَإِنَّا لَهُ لَحَافِظُونَ. It's done. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wants to teach us something more than that. You have to get out from your comfort zone. He went to Al-Habasha. And he wanted to give an example from himself. Then he went to Taif himself. And you know what happened to him in Taif. Nobody wants to hear him. But he didn't lose hope. He came back to Mecca. Even Mecca was closed at that time in his face. They say, no way you can come back. You have to have so-called protection or alliances. Himayatu fulan aw illan. Then one of the mushrikeen who does not even believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, walakin Allah sakhara. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought him to protect Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go back to Mecca. Jundullah. This is a lesson for us, brothers and sisters. We have to make an effort. Don't worry about the result. Put the effort there. Allah will bring jund min junudihi wama ya'lamu junud rabbika illa hu. Wama ya'lamu junud rabbika illa hu. This is a mushrik. Somebody who doesn't believe in Allah and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he brought him to protect Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to get him back to Mecca. And we are in the same situation today. We live in this society which is a multicultural society, multi-religion society. We are here in our comfort zone. We are in the comfort zone. The comfort zone meaning we come to the masjid, we pray, and we leave. Sit, done. You ask him, what's your name? He tell you, Muhammad and Ahmed and Rabi'a and Ruqayya. What do you do for Islam? What do you mean, brother? What do you have to do? I pray. It's enough, no? I give my zakat. Isn't it enough? I go to masjid. Isn't it enough? I make sadaqah to the masjid. Isn't it enough? I take my kids to the Islamic school. Is not enough? This is the primary, what they call it, obligations, duties. This is the primary duties toward yourself and your family. But where is the deen? What do we do for the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this country? Knowing that we live in this country, which is the superpower of this world. The international relations are adopted here in few miles from us. All the international policies are here. Then where is my share, my part to get out from my comfort zone and to go to follow Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his steps? To call for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To call those who are out there waiting for someone to save them from the hellfire. Someone to save them from their nafs. Forget about al-akhirah. To save them first from their nafs. Al-ambara to be su. To save them from all these diseases that we are living in today with today. This is why, brothers and sisters, for us, dhikr al-isra al-mi'raj, it's a good lesson for us to get out from our comfort zone. Al-ihtikak bil waqi'. We have to deal with the context that we are living in today. as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam dealt with it 1500 years ago. Al-Isra al-Mi'raj is another symbol of unity of Ummah. We cannot sit in the masjid and pray relaxed while the masjid al-Aqsa is crying. Allah said it clearly in the Quran, Subhana alladhi asra bi 'abdihi layla min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-Aqsa. Because al-masjid al-Aqsa, we want it or not, is our aqidah, is part of our iman, is part of la ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah, is part of me as human, is part of me as a Muslim. I should never let it down. Al-Masjid al-Aqsa, the responsibility of this masjid in my shoulder and yours, brothers and sisters. The third, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam led the prayer in the Masjid al-Aqsa, behind him, all the prophets. What does it mean? We belong to this world. Whatever happened to the Ummah somewhere, we have to feel it. We have to live with it. If they are crying, we have to cry. The least we can do is cry with them. إِن لَمْ تَسْتَطِيعُوا الْبُكَاءَ فَتَبَكَوْا كَمَا وَرَدَ فِي حَدِيثِ. If you cannot cry, just try. Because this is one ummah. This is the ummah التي اصطفاها الله لتقود العالم. هذه الأمة هي أمة القيادة وليست أمة التي تتبع. أتانا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لنقود العالم، ولكن لا يمكن أن نقوده بخلفية أخرى غير الخلفية القرآنية. يبد أن يكون القرآن هو المنهاج، وأن تكون سيرة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم هي الضياء، وأن يكون عمل الصحابة رضوان الله عليهم سنة لنا، وأن نخرج أنفسنا من هذه القوقعة التي نعيش فيها اليوم، وهي قوقعة التخلف، خاصة التخلف العلمي، إلى دائرة الفسح العلمي، دائرة أن نقود هذا العالم، أن يكون لنا موقع في هذا العالم. We get emotional. Sometimes we cry. We make dua just when something happened to the ummah. Yes, it's good. But is this enough? It's not enough, brothers and sisters. Because we are one body. وَأَنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمُ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً وَأَنَا رَبُّكُمْ فَاعْبُدُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose me and you to be among this ummah that he chose to be the ummah. But we have to do something about it, brothers and sisters. Tonight, or today is 26th. Rajab. The ulama, they said Isra al-Iraj happened. Some of them say it happened in Ramadan. Some of them say it happened in Shawwal. Some of them say it happened in Dhul Hijjah. But there are, I can say the majority, they say it happened in Rajab, the night of 26th, 27th, which is tonight. Before I close this khutbah, I have a request. اقرأوا سورة الإسراء الليلة. Read it with your family. Sit with your kids. It's good to talk to them about what happened in Isra al-Mi'raj, what happened when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam get the order for Salah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he met Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. He told him, go back. This is too much for your... It's all, this is good. It's perfect. I'm not saying no. But let those kids understand the context that we are living in. Let them understand the context of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let them understand what happened to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because I said it in many khutbah, I repeat it again. We have the same society as the one that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to live in. Same, exactly the same. الظلم, it's there. Transgression of the rules is there. absence of the social justice, you know it. Big difference, a gap between rich and poor, we have it today. Slavery, we have it today because we are slaves of the dollar. The bars, الخمارات, at that time, we have الخمارات today. The house of prostitution, we have it today. Arriba, we have it today. What's left? What's left? What's missing? Is قيادة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Is the leadership of Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم to get this society out from this bad behavior that we are living in. And they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept all of us. Our prayers, our sadaqat, our hasanat, our a'mal. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لكم استغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله المصطفى الأمين صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه. Brothers and sisters, as I mentioned, the lesson is we have to get out from this comfort zone. And the first step for this to happen to us is to link our heart to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To know that هو القاهر فوق عباده وهو القادر وهو المقتدر وهو القدير سبحانه وتعالى. Whatever he wants he can do. We depend on him. He doesn't depend on us. When we depend on him and we know that we depend on him and we know that he owns everything, including what we think or so-called that we own it, when we know that he owns it, he is the real owner, then we are in the first step toward that تزكية النفوس ومن بعد تزكية النفوس إلى المجاهدة ومن بعد المجاهدة إلى الخروج للدعوة إلى الله. This is the first step, brothers and sisters. Second step is we feel that we are part of this ummah. And I mean it. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, today I came on behalf of Islamic Relief to ask not your donations, to ask you to take that step toward believing in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is huwa al-razzaq, nobody else. We need to support our brothers and sisters in Syria and Turkey. The latest news says we are at 42,000 dead. And they are still counting. We don't know how many. Allah knows. The whole city is destroyed in Turkey. We have a team right now in the ground. They are sending us daily reports from there. والله الذي لا إله غيره. If you have ذرة إيمان in your heart, the atom of belief in your heart, you will be crying when you see these videos. People are on the street. This is Turkey. This is one of the most Muslim countries which is developed. صح, it's developed, but they are suffering. Talk about Syria. Syria وما أدرك ما سوريا الشام. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يعتق رقاب الشاميين. It's disaster. It's worse than you can imagine. I came today to ask your support, please. This masjid جزاهم الله خيرا. جزاهم الله خير. Partnered with the Islamic Relief. Now for almost 2 weeks they are collecting funds. But today I came myself to ask you to do this good deed, inshallah rahim. Don't leave this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala until we show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are patient. Sabr. Hatta sabr ala ata. We know that we don't have money, but we are going to give it. Sabr. Inna ma yuwaffa as-sabiruna ajrahum bighayri hisab. والصبر على الطاعة، الصبر على النفاق، الصبر على أن نقول لنا إخوان لنا في سوريا وتركيا يعانون اليوم، كل هذا صبر نحتسبه عند الله سبحانه وتعالى. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to all of us. Inshallah, after Jumu'ah, after Salah, I will be standing for 2 minutes trying to collect what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided us to collect. Please, don't leave this house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala unless you give something. If you are in a rush, you can stop by the office. You give them whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allows you to give, inshallah, marahim. And inshallah, marahim. Let us show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala some gratitude because we swim in ni'ams. We have the abundance of ni'am, but this ni'mah needs a lot of shukr. And one of the ways of making shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving fi sabilillah. Allahumma aghfir lana dunubana, kabiraha wa saghiraha, azimaha wa haqiraha. Allahumma ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala dinik. Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala dinik. Ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala dinik. Allahumma ansurna ala anfusina. Allahumma ansurna ala anfusina. اللهم ثبتنا على القول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارحم والدينا كما ربنا الصغار. اللهم زين بإحسان إحسانا وبالسيئات عفوا ومغفرة يا أكرم الكرمين يا رب العالمين. ربنا عليك توكلنا ولك بناوك المصير، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بك. اللهم ارحم موتانا وموتى المسلمين. اللهم اغفر لهم وارحمهم وعافهم واعف عنهم واغسلهم بالماء والثلج والبرد ونقهم من الخطايا كما ينقطب الأبيض من الدرس يا أكرم الكرمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم كل إخواننا في تركيا وفي سوريا، اللهم كل إخواننا في فلسطين، اللهم كل إخواننا في كوسوفو، اللهم كل إخواننا في كشمير، اللهم كل إخواننا في الصين، اللهم كل إخواننا في كل مكان يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم يا مقلب القلوب، يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك، يا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك يا أرحم الراحمين يا رب العالمين. اللهم احفظ مؤسسات المسلمين، اللهم احفظ مؤسسات المسلمين، اللهم احفظ مؤسسات المسلمين من عبث العابثين ونفاق المنافقين وخداع المخادعين يا أكرم الأكرمين يا رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك، نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، نستغفرك وأتوب إليك. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون، وسلام على المرسلين، والحمد لله رب العالمين، وأقم الصلاة.